Dark Blark.
Dark Blark. Blark.
We are more and more often starting over in the builds, aren't we? That
yeah.
used to be different. Did we switch something around?
We used to play this game for fun.
I still do that.
Oh, somebody's got to dig.
Yes. Last replace.
Yeah, that's not for fun if you're gathering things for the...
It's fun for me.
Why
I
is...
do it to relax sometimes. Okay.
Where is a... Why is this a unicorn skull?
Yeah, that I didn't understand.
I just wanted a horn on there.
Okay.
I guess can't argue that.
Can I ask also why you're putting water in my diesel train?
Because it needed to be cooled down. It was on fire.
That was also disgust, actually.
Yeah, I was like, I know that this doesn't make sense because it's a diesel train, which means it's a giant electric generator, but you know what? Al gets water.
Mine should have gotten
say,
water.
I want to say, like, I'm super impressed with the water dispenser. I saw that and it was instantly, but I thought, like, why isn't it Joe who actually has a steam train?
Yeah, yes. And that was just because it was further over.
Okay.
Simple logistics.
Really interesting idea, and it really got a lot of conversation, and it was, I don't know. One thing I can figure out.
I feel like I messed you up, Joe, because when I was building over there by you, I wasn't thinking that we would all three have locomotives. I was like, oh, have other kinds of train cars. And so I was starting to build like a flat car,
mm-hmm.
and you built like a thing on top of it that looks fine. I feel like you could have done better if I just left you alone.
Well, it was confusing. I definitely debated for a while what to do. Also, how do the trains get into that place?
I mean, how'd they get into that?
Both ends of the tracks. Both ends of the tracks are blocked off.
It's a I don't know. It's like a factory.
Well, you're the one arguing about water into a diesel train. This is a fairly. It was a fairly. Everyone apparently knows a fair bit about trains, and everyone who was on was discussing. Like, well, does this make sense? I understand that it's whimsical, but it's also. For the amount of detail, and for the train guy especially, I was a little like, well, plus at one point I was like, oh, I want to build out, you know, like send the trucks out maybe a bit past the thing, and I was like, well, that's not the end that they come in on, and then I went to the other end, and I was like, well, apparently they got brought here by helicopter. Like you do with trains.
That'd be a hell of a helicopter if it's bringing train
engines. Like six QEs.
I thought it worked. I'm sorry. It didn't.
It worked! Oh, God, that's right. You're still in your head. I forgot.
Yeah, Al's, Al has been... lacking confidence in the past week because of the dirt block.
It worked just fine.
Okay.
Why am I even going to the dirt block? I don't have any dirt.
I have some dirt. I put some... So I had some from last dirt
block. I was
block
just about
that
to ask that.
Put in a chest.
I was just about to ask that. What's the ruling there? Because I filled up on dirt and then we ended. And I was like, well, okay.
I've always just brought it from the chest. Like... That's why there's a chest in front of here, and I just stole two stacks of dirt so I could be the first one to lay dirt today.
You're
taking my dirt!
I'm three rows in, dude.
What's that?
I'm three rows in, mister. Oh. Learn your facts before you...
Oh!
Burn!
Sick burn.
Oh, this is awesome. The sun's setting over... This is pretty sweet.
Yeah, it's awesome. Except for we're about gonna die.
Well, yeah, that. Bok, 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 bok. Do you take any damage when you hit slime?
I don't think so. Whoa.
So we could technically still jump off the dirt block if we can manage to hit that slime down there, huh?
Yep.
Not down here.
Or you could fall from like it. You could fall from orbit and not take any damage if you land
orbit,
on slime cubes.
Also, the penis over there is pretty great. I might make a heart over here. Penis heart. I love penis.
Joe loves the Pinot.
Yes. Pinot Noir. Hi, Mr. Spider.
Have you ever seen Sideways? Ooh. I never saw that one. I saw some quotes from it that seemed like it was pretty funny for a movie about a wine tasting.
Yeah, it was a good little movie. It was a little, like, became the darling of that, like, Oscar period. Maybe a little overrated, but definitely got, you know, if you're seeing it outside of the hype, you're probably in looking for just a good little movie. Yeah, that's a damn fun film. But people are like, this is, you know, breakout role for, I mean, it was probably for Giamatti, but... They also were discussing how good the other guy was, which he was in the movie, but it wasn't exactly a
Thomas
launching
Hayden
point
Church
for a massive career. Yeah.
Wow, that's a lot of spiders.
Al, are you still on the call?
I'm still on the call.
Okay. Just want to make sure you weren't saying things thinking we could hear you.
Nope. It's just OBS Studio has totally crashed.
Alt F4.
What am I going to do with Alt F4?
Kill the program and restart?
It's stopping recording, Tony. I don't want to lose my footage that I did record.
The like 14 seconds of dirt block we got.
It's true. It might be a cut now, cut losses. What's the saying? Cutlasses?
Cut, fish or cut bait?
Cut your losses?
Something like that? Yeah.
Cut with the grain?
Cutter. John Cutter?
John Cutter Mellencamp?
John Cutter of Mars?
Mr. Mellencamp was actually playing at Atlantic City when I was there this past weekend.
I didn't know you went to Atlantic City this weekend.
Sort of impromptu, yeah. A birthday thing. Actually, incredibly impromptu. Yes.
Joe is 1 year older.
Chatting with a friend from...
Everything is the worst. Everything is super sucky.
Talk about death. Yes. No. But yeah, I was randomly chatting with my friend from Philly, and we were kind of just like, AC. Birthday? AC. And then that happened. And then as we were driving in, you see all the signs for who's in town, and Mellencamp was there. Did not see him, though. Opted to lose money and get drunk instead.
It's always a good choice.
Yes.
I don't know who John Mellencamp is.
Jack and Diane? Little ditty. About who's Jack that? And Diane. Two American kids growing up. There's just death everywhere. Yeah,
this is even worse than usual. I don't understand.
Yeah,
I feel like I'm not even in this one, and I'm very sorry.
Well, you're providing hilarious commentary.
As I sit here trying to troubleshoot my footage.
That's what we were saying. You should maybe cut. I mean, at this point now, you're missing out on even more. I think it's time to just get into the dirt block and forget your earlier footage. That's what I would do. It is a game time decision that you have to make for yourself. However,
okay.
We're having tons of fun. I mean, you're just going to come in and die 84 times because it's a really bad night footage, for some though. Reason. It's like a blood moon or something. What?
Yes, zombie, help me kill the skeleton.
Oh, that's nice when they aggro each other.
Man, this is violent up in here right now.
Yeah, I finally dug myself into a nice dirt digging area where there's nothing. Proof is in the pudding or something.
I don't want any pudding.
You're pudding.
Oh, this is great. Yeah, come at me now, stupid zombies.
Puddinghead Wilson!
Mark Twain.
Is that like a former president?
Hey, you know the reference!
About fingerprints. It's like, by the way, these fingerprint things came out, and I'm going to write a whole book about them.
Why did you set me on fire?
Basically
how did you
the
do
Michael
that?
Crichton method, right?
True. Yeah. It's just for Mark Twain, it was weird in my mind, because that's not... I mean, I'm not saying anything against Mark Twain, it just is not usually what he did.
What are you saying against Mark Twain, Joe?
He's dumb.
Oh, yeah.
He didn't know anything about fingerprints until he wrote that book.
He was just like jumping on the fingerprint train, like, oh,
pretty
yeah.
Much. That's what it felt like.
Another fingerprint book.
Mark Twain sets trends. He doesn't follow them. Fingerprint.
Yeah, he
analysis.
Was the one who started Vampire Romance.
Yeah. What? There's a
what
subtext.
Is that?
Subtext to Tom Sawyer that most people don't know about.
Yeah.
Oh, or is this like a Seth Graham Smith thing?
Who's what? Seth Graham Smith?
Yes. That's what it is. This is a Tony and I are talking out of our ass thing, as far as I know. That's the joke
I'm
running with.
That's pretty much it.
Okay.
He started Twilight.
Seth Graham Smith wrote Abraham Lincoln versus Zombies.
Oh.
Not versus Zombies. I'm sorry. Abraham Lincoln Vampire Hunter.
Right.
He does the, and also Pride and Prejudice and Zombies. He does the revisionist, like, Tom Sawyer and Vampires.
Well, chirp, blark.
It is very much a death block tonight.
Yeah.
He's also kind of, like, fallen off my... I thought, like, this is pretty cool when he first came out with Pride and Prejudice and Zombies. And then Abraham Lincoln, Vampire Hunter, didn't turn out to be as good. And I wasn't interested in the book. And now he's, like... I saw something that had him in it, and I was like, more Seth Graham Smith.
Is it just going back to the well again?
No, it was, like, How to Survive a Horror Movie. So it wasn't...
I picked up that book on Audible for, like, $1.50.
Yeah. It was almost free, and I still wasn't interested, because it was like, I don't want to be associated with this guy.
Endorsed by Albert Berg. If you hit that button, that's what happens. That pops up on the for everyone else on Audible. Do you say that you've read a book when you've done it on Audible, listened to it on Audible?
Yeah.
Is that the terminology?
I mean,
I've said I'd listen, but it's like people are like, oh, you should take the extra effort and read it. It's like, yeah, 5-year-olds can read. Anybody can listen. Like, it's not like a big deal because you actually looked at words on a page. I actually went and got like a 4-mile walk done while I listened to your book.
All right, Mr. Defensive.
Who says that they're going to, like, that you have to read?
I've heard so many people that are like, audiobooks aren't really reading.
There is,
they're not really reading. Like, that's true.
Yeah, but they're, like, saying that you're not, like...
It's not true in any way that matters.
Yeah.
Yeah, unless you're talking about, like, brain waves or, like...
elitist about it. They're like, you can't say that you've actually, like, that you understand literature if you've listened to an audiobook.
Well, that's not true at all.
Maybe.
First of all, it's insulting to blind people.
Yeah. Let's have a test about literature.
So that's like saying if you compose a book on your computer, you're not really writing.
Yeah.
You're not really writing.
Or if you smell Mozart, you aren't really hearing Mozart.
Well, what?
I don't know. I was going with the sense thing. Different senses for the...
No, it's just the hearing and
you rub a record on your face, you're not really hearing the music.
Okay,
what?
See, no. Whose side are you on here, Joe?
The giggling side.
The what side? It sounded like you said the healing side.
The giggling side.
Oh, the giggling side. I thought you were like going to cleric on us or something.
Yes. Everyone be healed. I'd like to talk to you all about Jesus Christ.
That is kind of your like shtick in video games, though. You like being the support slash healer
role. Oh, I love being
role.
Support. Yes.
Whereas I'm like the, I want to break things roll or tank things roll.
You never do like DP, you don't sniper though, you sort of tank mostly.
Mostly.
Like the tank is basher, so it's not really DPS, which is odd because you also like breaking things. But there's no like, I don't know, it's interesting. Because you also, you don't like to be vulnerable. You like to wade in there and kind of bash things, but in the end that isn't actually the damage dealer. Which is more about video games than...
But it also makes you feel like you're the tough guy that, like, takes, like, 50 hits and keeps going.
Yes. I mean, I agree. But it's weird that when in video games, like, the... What you would think of as, like, the Norse warrior actually ends up being just the damage sponge and not the deep damage dealer.
Yeah. But it is a really cool feeling whenever you're, like, the head of a raid and you've got 30 people, like, healing you and trying to kill the other thing while this giant dragon is focused only on you.
Yeah, when you're the wall. I definitely did some tanking. It's pretty sweet. But
what is this
had...
game we're talking about?
Any game.
World of Warcraft,
the Holy
EverQuest, any of those MMO games, really.
The Holy Trilogy. Okay.
So
of,
not any game.
No, like, just whenever you're a tank rolling in those MMOs. Like, EverQuest was such a strange game back in the day. I used to lead raids of, like, 80 people at times.
That's just nuts.
And there wasn't any sort of, like, group dynamics. You had to make your own groups and just have everything, like, in spreadsheets and try to figure out, like, healing orders and lots of really weird things that you just had to pay very, very close attention to.
It's very different. I never
And this is live action, too. It's not like we're going to take, there's not, like, a turn-based thing built into the game.
Yeah.
I say live action. I mean, it's still a computer game, but you know what I mean. Like,
there are no turns. It's all, like... 50 people doing different things at the same time trying to kill a boss and all that.
That almost went too far the other way at the end of World of Warcraft, where you would get so many mods that healing was just like, click the green bar, that's the lowest, and it would just figure out, like, it was really not.
EverQuest did not have that. Like, it also had a much, much more difficult death system because your gear didn't transfer with you in death, so you were just naked, and you would lose 5 or 6 hours worth of, like, grinding experience if you died.
Yep.
So, like,
that
the penalties
definitely,
were huge.
Definitely started to shift as I got more.
They went
popular.
A little more casual. Which, at first, I was like, this is annoying, because, like, you can just die over and over again, and then I was like, oh, I like this, because I don't have time.
Yes.
Because you can just die over and over again.
Yeah.
Yep.
Like, those corpse runs when you're going into, like, a god's plane and you're just dying over and over and you're seeing all of your friends lose 20, 30 hours worth of work. Those were some stressful times.
Actually, that, oddly enough, Minecraft replicates that nowadays.
Yeah.
When you're watching,
your stuff
just
explodes.
Yep. Or you just, well, okay, yes. If you put 2 thermonuclear warheads as decoration in front of the dirt block and then accidentally light them on fire. But I've definitely had runs where I'm like, oh, God, that was a great piece of, great chess piece, and just blindly locked in and kept going back over and over again, not successfully.
Or when you get accidentally shot by Tony doing a no-scope, no-look.
Like 360 no-scope.
Oh, you need
no
some
scope.
Help? Let me just sort of wave in that direction with my bow and arrow.
This is MLG Pro Gaming right here.
Did that make it into one of our... That's the opposite, because you killed him, Tony.
No, like I was just saying, like 360 no-scope.
Yes.
Your ally, again.
Ostensibly my ally. You never know whenever he's going to be trying to kill me.
In Tony's head, we're all at any given point an enemy.
An enemy?
Is that one of our bumper reels now?
Yes.
Okay.
I actually just pulled that in the promo thing because I was working on the Dirt Block live action video, which is uploaded for you guys to look at. Might be block. Out by the time this video comes out.
Oh, right. I saw that in our queue and I was like, what the hell? We always do Dirt Block live. Ish. Like, what is that? What is I see. In the real world, IRL, if you will.
Yeah. Or I would have called it IRL, but I already had a folder called IRL, and like I tried to I was like, I want to type in Dirt Block IRL, because that's what I was using. And then it was like, all right, well, we're in the folder now. What do you want? I was like, no. I don't want to save it in the Dirt Block IRL folder. I want to save it in the videos folder and call it dirtblockirl.mp4.
What?
And they were like, okay, so we're in the Dirt Block IRL folder now. It's like, no, you don't understand. I want to call the file Dirt Block IRL.
Do you talk to your computer?
What?
Do you talk to your computer?
No, Joseph, this is storytelling. Okay, this is for the purpose of entertainment.
I can see the YouTube subscriber towers from the Dirt Block. Like, the far end of the Dirt Block. That's awesome.
And by the time this one goes up, we'll probably have a ninth tower up.
Be sweet. Sweet.
It'll be close.
I also, this is somewhat related to that, because, okay, you popped into the stream last night, or someone, I thought that was you, you're the one who usually does the subscriber pushes, and was like, we're going for whatever by October. Is that you?
Yes.
Okay, that's what I figured. And then my brain went to Nightbot. Someone has also brought up Nightbot in my stream last night. We need to get you a couple hours again with Nightbot, because that feels a little underutilized. Great comedic content while we're twitching, but... Basically, he just comes on and is like, looks like the oblivious friend that has no idea what's happening, but just keeps saying the same things over and over again.
I'm sorry, you want to get in there and, like, tune Nightbot to be able to understand when we're having, like, conversations that it shouldn't interrupt?
He can do more than just bounce on randomly and say, hey, do you like this? Don't subscribe. Right? Can he, like, we were talking about having, like, a currency of some sort and,
Yeah, like, where people get, like, waffles or something.
Not waffles, because that's waffles is a stick.
Yes.
Stick.
What would be our stick? What do people get?
Oh, yeah. What do people get? What's
they
our currency?
Thinkingofanecklace.com.
No. When you,
that's,
for watching,
that's what they get for us.
Yes. What's our currency on Twitch? What's our
Al's
Twitch
children.
Currency? Al's children?
I said,
yeah, no,
yes. Al Bird will reproduce for every 10 hours you're on the on the stream.
I'm fine with that.
That would be so weird.
Lining the ladies up, that's the problem.
That would be so weird. That's the weirdest promotion I've ever heard of. I don't know what. Oh, God.
Another bird baby.
No,
line
for
up,
instance.
Ladies, for the fertility of the bird.
If you watch for 10 minutes, you get a credit. And then, like, we'll say things like, well, who wants to do... X.
Yeah, you can gamble it, and you can, like, trade it, and, like, if you get enough, you can, like, buy a spot on the realm or join for something. Like, there's all sorts of different things.
But we wouldn't call them credits. We'd call them Albert Berg's children.
Just call them Bergs.
What was the first science fiction story to call money credits?
Well, I'm sure if you Googled it, you could have the answer.
Huh.
I'm asking you, because it's one of those ubiquitous, like, things in science fiction that everybody's... Sort of.
What are they?
It's like, when did we dump the dollar for credits? People actually had money, but it was just paper. These are digital and they matter more.
I mean, that's today.
Yeah.
We still call them dollars, though.
I was Dogecoin mining this week just for the sake of it. I got like 14 cents worth of Dogecoin.
I've never gotten into the mining part.
The cryptocurrencies.
Foundation is credits. That's at least back to the. I forget when he wrote that. That's early. That's my first time marker for that question, Mr. Berg.
What was the first science fiction story to use credits as money? Let's ask Google.
So you want to be in Dirt Block IRL? That was funny in my head.
Stack Exchange.
Damn it.
Let's see.
See, because Al currently earlier was saying when he talked to his computer, it kept going to Dirtblock IRL. He was just talking to his computer and it sent him to Dirtblock IRL in my head. It was hilarious if you could have been inside my head. as most things are. That's not how jokes work, though. You have to say them out loud.
I'm pretty good at getting inside your head sometimes.
So I'm very excited for... This will be out. Well, we're doing it the Thursday before Halloween. Well, no, because Halloween's on a stupid Monday. But Thursday before what I'm considering the Halloween weekend, we're doing a spooky games night stream, which is going to be
awesome. It'll be very spooky.
And Tony gets to pick the game I play. I'm putting him
according to this guy who has an OED, which I don't because my parents didn't buy me one for Christmas, but they bought one for my sister because they love her more.
What's an OED?
Oxford English Dictionary.
Oh.
Yeah, that's totally something all of us know.
I probably would have figured that out if I'd backtracked enough to remember what I was doing. Okay, yeah. Credits, go.
1937 serialized story Galactic Patrol was the first one that would use it in the sense that we would call it. There's one from like 1897 that sort of mentioned credits as like in the sort of sense that we would use them, like that you would get credits for like actual credit.
But it wasn't a currency. It was just like a...
Right. It wasn't used in the sense of like instead of dollars.
It was like a favor or something.
So what is our currency? Octoshark eggs?
That's not bad.
Oaf juice bottles?
Oh!
How about times that Albert's footage records? How about that being a good currency?
Albert's footage.
It's lost to time.
We should just ask our...
Like, we could call our credits like dadgum, since that's like kind of your catchphrase.
Dadgum, dadgum, dadgum. No, it's got to be something. Al's too much in the spotlight recently.
Yes.
Mr. Berg, I'm picking you down a peg.
That's fine.
It's got to be something from either Tony or I. Everything's Berg. I realize you, in your head right now, you're the worst thing ever, but, I mean, you're on the second pin, for Christ's sake. We got to mix this up a little bit. I don't have any
ideas.
Are you
singing the dadgum dag? Or no, hot dog, hot diggity dog?
Yes, that was a big thing with my... It still is with one of my nieces.
I was going to say, I didn't know your youngins were that young.
When I was watching them, they were. And then it's still on. And one of them is... I've got a newer one that came along.
That's a lot of skeletons. Skeleton on skeleton crime. They're fighting each other.
Oh no! Like, spider like spawned directly on top of me. Why don't we have an iron golem up here?
What?
We should totally make an iron golem up here. They're useless, but it would be awesome.
It would be.
Don't
do
they
we
fight
have
mobs?
Yeah,
they
but
do.
Really not great DPS.
Yeah, but they've got 100 health, so that they can at least absorb some stuff. They could tank for us.
Yeah, that's true.
All right, Al, your job now. Actually, we need somebody with footage.
Well, is there one?
No, we could add one though.
Al said there was one.
No, I said we need one.
Oh, why don't we have one? I thought you said, why is there one? Okay, check. Got it. I forgot how to make them. Ow! Bastard. Oh, no, you're a bastard.
A lot of iron, but I don't think that's a problem on this server.
No, we're pretty good on iron. Even with the iron we used last night, I used some iron in my...
It's going to be
the
so
bridge
fun
wiped
telling
us out pretty good.
Plays that he has to do everything
by
again.
The way, I want to point out, both of y'all complained about on the train build that the trains were inside the tracks.
Yes.
What trains are you watching that just rides like on top of the train track?
What?
You know the ones where it's on the rails?
Yeah, no, they go on the inside of the rails. That's how they stay on, Tony. That's how they know where to go.
What?
It just didn't look right.
I mean, they sort of hug the rails. The wheels go on the rails.
They go on the inside.
I'm lost. I was talking about the bumpers on either side. Like, how would the train have driven into that area?
No. When you streamed, you made the comment about
possibly.
The wheels being inside the rails, and I thought about that very, like, very thoroughly. I was like, this is, like, they're angled in, and they ride, like, on the inside of the rails. I mean, granted, yes, they touch the top of the rails.
Okay, that's fair enough. I think that was just a little difficult to convey in Minecraft blocks.
Yes.
And Al, Tony and I read it the opposite way.
Okay.
And you were seeing it the one way. I understand, I guess. That's fair enough. What I did understand was why the wheels were misplaced. Not misplaced. That was a terrible word to use. Miss Uneven spread out? Was that on purpose?
On my engine?
Yeah.
Yeah.
On the start of my
engine. They go in groups.
Okay. That's because I was wondering.
Not like just like evenly spaced out, like here's a wheel and here's a wheel and here's a wheel.
That I debated. I was like, I don't know if Al did this on purpose or if or not would be the other option.
Again, if you had like a look at what I was working from.
Fair enough. Well, that one I was definitely like, he could have been going for the spacing between wheels on a locomotive, or he could have miscounted.
Come on, creepers. There's like a totally vulnerable owl over on the other side. Leave me alone.
That's a good point, actually. I should not be. I'm right on the edge, too.
Living on the edge. All right.
All you get from me is murder. You could at least get your kill count up if you go over there.
Living on the edge. Oh, boy.
Got him.
Hmm. Whoop. Nope.
Have you ever seen it? Aerosmith live, Joe?
Wow.
No.
Neither have I.
Would be. I've heard they're pretty damn good.
They're also like 75 now.
Die. Boom.
Well, that means they're really experienced. They're
playing
musical instruments. The Stones. They still put on
like
a good show.
The Stones like just kill it still.
Yeah. AC/DC. I mean, good God.
That's a show I need to see before they stop touring.
Yeah. They were amazing. And then at one point we're sitting there with my cousin, and he's just like, that lead singer is the same age as my dad. And I was just like, oh my God. AC/DC's story is just bizarre.
What's their story?
Can you discuss that? So they were a pretty good band out of Australia, had a number of hits, Dirty Deeds.
Hey, you bastard, put that block down.
They were terrible.
Fuck off, Frienderman.
And then their lead singer, Bon Scott, died. He choked on his vomit while passed out. Just a stupid, weird way to go.
One of those drug things from the 60s?
Or
possibly just really drunk?
He wasn't that, no, different.
Oh, he was definitely a hardcore drunk. Like,
yes.
One
I mean,
of
they're not a, every song they sing is either about drinking or sex. Like, they're not, that's definitely
sometimes
fits
murder.
In with their, what?
Sometimes dirty deeds and murder.
Yes, there's a couple moments of murder as well. However, so, you know, that it was like lead singer, they had a couple big albums and it was like, you know, I guess it's time to call it quits. They discussed a lot about like what they were going to do. Usually something like that happens. The band's over. They never quite get back to where they were at. They decided they would, you know, that he wouldn't want that. And they started auditioning for a new singer. They went through a bunch of people. They found one guy who they were like, okay, this guy works, Brian Johnson, their current singer. And they're like, well, put together an album and see how it goes. The first album they put out with this new guy is Back in Black. It's the number one best-selling album like ever. Just an absolute monumental, huge piece of music. And just sort of came out of nowhere. It's just bizarre. You don't like, you don't lose the key member of your band and then come back and make the greatest album like in your genre of all time.
Like an immortal rock album, because that still sounds good today.
Oh my God. I mean, that's where You Shook Me All Night Long is from. It's where Back in Black, obviously, is from. It's Highway to Hell. No, Highway to Hell.
Thunderstruck's not on that one, is it?
No, that's on, shoot, I should know that. I forget what it's on, though. But no, that's not Thunderstruck. But that is, Thunderstruck is Brian Johnson. Like, they're still doing good stuff with Brian Johnson. Just crazy. All right.
Whoa,
I've got...
I just legitimately got a snow block. Or, I mean, not a snow block. I was looking at the snowmen being made. I got a grass block without having to use hacks for it or smooth touch because I killed the Enderman who stole a block from me.
Ah.
I'm almost tempted to keep that for like some sort of build that we need like grass to start growing.
I'm sure there's does the loot hole have silk touch?
I'm sure one of them does. But that, like, that's been a thing in a lot of different builds where it's like, well, I don't have grass. It's going to take forever to, like, build a ramp.
Yeah, especially
oh,
that garden.
Witch, why? Why, witch,
walking,
why?
Walking right into him. I thought
I
you were going to kill him.
Into a witch.
Oh, you're going backwards. I didn't notice.
I am poisoned.
Yes, this was a terrible idea I had. This is not the same as an iron golem, and it's annoying, and they're terrible.
And they're going to burn up, like, as soon as it rains.
Yes.
So when you see a speedy animal or skeleton or whatever, is that because a witch hit them with a potion of speed?
Probably.
Or do they just sometimes spawn?
I think spiders spawn.
Okay.
Skeletons, I don't know. I don't know if the rifts go around
severely
the whiffs.
Poisoned. I have 1.5 hearts left.
Poison will not actually kill you.
I have a half a heart. I'm just going to stay over here and not die, hopefully. But there is a spider up there.
Yeah, but now it's a friendly spider.
Protect me, snow golems.
Yeah, they're just kind of wandering around. They're not the defenders I was hoping they'd be.
Yeah, now it's going to be harder to place blocks. Oh, you're invisible.
Am I?
Yeah.
Yes. Still have that problem. Nice.
Now I'm just going to
steal
up
all
your
this
placement.
Experience. Oh, wait. Why am I? I've been trying not to talk about what I'm seeing on my screen because nobody else can see it. This spider block, it's very distracting for me.
You can fill it in later.
Yeah, just
draw pictures.
Animate
it. Draw it in MS Paint.
You draw it, Tony.
I mean, this would be pretty easy to draw.
That's
compared to a lot of things.
Who built snow golems? I said iron golems.
Oh, yeah, I didn't have iron, but I was next to snow when you said that, so.
Well, now we're going to have snow all over the dirt block.
Yep.
The snow block.
It's not really all over. And is that corner, that far corner is still a snow biome, right?
Yeah. Now that you just said the snow block, I realized we could absolutely have snow golems like producing snow like a factory and just go around and mine it up and make blocks.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, you can actually pin them in a way that you can just sit there and hit underneath and it's thousands of snowballs.
Oh my god. Oh wow, he lived and then made snow instantly. Interesting.
Did you kick somebody off the dirt block?
They're not real people, right? Snow golems? So are we treating them like real people? Because I just shoved one off the dirt block when he was in my way.
Well, you made him. You can take him out.
I am your god. You will leave me out of this thing and space it out when I give you the order. What?
Oh, no! I killed one, too. I was trying to get him. Yay, there we go.
Oh, you made it into an actual snowman. In the meadow, Al can build a snowman.
Woohoo!
He's Parson Brown.
Alright, I'm looking up Snow Golem because I have a bunch of iron here.
Iron Golem.
I'm looking up, we're about ready to stop recording the dirt block.
Yes.
Oh, we're going to finish the Iron Golem first.
Look at him! Okay. Oh, I didn't realize that all goofy charcoal face.
Alright, who's got a pumpkin?
I do.
Alright.
Really,
it's an iron and a tea and a pumpkin. Like, it's not difficult.
Yep, I have the iron. I am on my way.
Send me on my way. On my way.
Did you guys see the Richie Plays video where he built the golem, iron golem dispenser?
I saw the title for that and flagged it as something I needed to watch, but have not actually checked it out yet.
You just push a button. It pushes out the stuff for the iron golem, and then a dispenser drops the pumpkin on the top of the head, and you just, like, have an iron golem.
That's amazing.
That's pretty awesome.
It's pretty awesome, yes.
I guess I could... Well, no. How does he make the... Well, I'll watch it. Yeah, are we winding... What are we doing here?
We are building an iron golem.
I said we should wind down.
No, we have to finish... Tony wants to build the iron golem to finish this off. There's or we could start the next one with an iron golem.
So much jumping. Get up the hill.
We could build stairs, but then it would just be...
Tearing them down later.
Yeah.
Ah! We would have... Right. Listen, if we... Of all the stuff we have to do later, the stairs is like the last thing.
Yeah.
All right, Joe, where are you at?
I just threw a pumpkin at you.
I think I just tried to place it on you.
I don't think that's how that works. I'll do it.
I just want to point out how happy I am that we had a whole nother segment of talking about music on this dirt block.
Yeah, but we were talking about real music. Not like your perceived music.
What? I don't know what that meant. Yay, we have an iron golem. Woo!
Woo!
Your name is...
Pubert.
Your name is Pubert. What? And we're done.
Bye, everybody.
Goodbye.
Bye. If you know anything about Minecraft, you know that almost everything in the game is made out of blocks. What you might not know is that in the game, those blocks are represented as being 1 meter wide by 1 meter long by 1 meter deep. In the game, it takes 0.15 seconds to mine one of these dirt blocks with an iron shovel. We mine hundreds of them in our dirt block Let's Play in our quest to build a 64 by 64 by 64 cube of dirt. But lately I've been wondering, what would it take to dig out a 1 meter cube of dirt in real life? Is, ladies and gentlemen, a 1 meter cube hole in actual dirt. All told, this took me a little over an hour to dig out, but I'm a little out of shape and I took several lemonade breaks, so I guesstimate that you could probably do about one every 20 minutes if you really put your mind to it. I did the math and I figured out that if I was building the real 64 by 64 by 64 dirt block at a rate of 20 minutes per block, it would take me 42 years to complete it, working 8-hour days, 5 days a week. But at least then I wouldn't be getting shot by skeletons all the time. So that's a plus, right?